seated. On behalf of the family, I want to say thank you for coming and being with them today and in the past week in their time of need. And so on the behalf of the family, thank you for being here and ministering to the family and supporting the family. We're here today to say how much Miss Tommy Jean Robinson meant to each one of you and to this family especially. She is survived by two sons, Bobby Rose and Susan, Paul Robinson and Teresa, grandchildren Travis Rose, David Robinson, and Tegan Robinson. Some things about Miss Tommy that I got informed on this week as I spent some time with the family. I knew her briefly on occasion. She would have come to the church and be there for the grandchildren when they would be performing something, maybe for Christmas or for Easter or something like that. But some things that you probably knew better than I did about Miss Tommy, in fact, that she was a very caring person. She cared for her family most of all. And she never again missed an opportunity to be there for you as a family when something came up that she could celebrate life with. Bobby was just telling me just a minute ago that you had taken several trips down to Florida with her and Key West and those places. She never missed an opportunity to celebrate life with her friends and her family. Again, her grandchildren and her children and your friends were important to her. Another one of her traits was she loved not only family and friends, but I understand she loved animals too, especially cats. I saw the bowling ball in there that had the cat engraved on it. So no question that she loved people, she loved animals, she just loved everybody. She was, in her caring trait was that I understand she liked to listen. People need listeners. Sometimes all we just need to say is there something bothering you and something you need to get off your chest and something you need to talk about? But I understand Miss Tommy was an excellent listener. And if you ask her, she not only was a good listener, but if you really wanted to, she would give you the advice that she thought you might need to help you in that opportunity that you'd opened up with her. Listening skills are something that's missing today. Used to be a time when people would sit on their front porches and just spend time with family and listen to each other. I'm glad that Miss Tommy took the time to listen, and when the opportunities came to tell you what she thought maybe would help you with your problem. She loved doing things. I understand that she loved to take people that needed a ride on transportation. David was telling me a while ago when the accident happened, all those things, a lot of those things that were back there on the table were in her automobile with her when the accident happened. If I understand some things about Miss Tommy was this, the reason all those things were in her car was because if she found somebody who needed something, it was going to be available. She wouldn't have to run back to the house or somewhere else. She had it in the car to give out. So that's the kind of person that I think I heard Miss Tommy was. She was caring and wanting to give anybody anything that needed. She loved to make blankets and make the opportunity to give out cards. How many of you ladies have a hat on the day that she made? Any of you ladies? I know that she loved to make hats. In fact, that was another one of her special things that she loved to do and loved to share with sharing those hats that she made. She loved to take pictures and loved to take videos and share those pictures with videos with people. In fact, I understand they're videoing the service today for those maybe who can't be here. That was her. She wanted to have pictures and wanted to have videos, and not just to have them, but have the opportunity to share them. Along with all those things, she also loved to paint and do pottery. If you saw again some of the handiwork she had back in the other side of the building. She enjoyed making them, and she enjoyed sharing them. That's the main thing, is not just making things, but have the opportunity to make those things and then share those things. Again, David was telling me that they would take old doors and make things out of them, tables and things, and give them away. And so that's just the kind of love and the kind of person she was. She was active in also the annual senior games. I understand that she tried just about anything that the senior games could do. Her specialty was bowling. She loved to bowl, and part of the bowling was she was part of a bowling league for a long, long time. I think if anybody could be the Energizer Bunny, it probably was Miss Tommy, because she just didn't stop for anything. She lived in a variety of locations in her life, including Whitmire, and she went to Germany one time. She didn't just love living in those places. If my understanding was, she loved to tell you about where she lived. She enjoyed not only living there, but she enjoyed taking the opportunity to share those memories that she had made wherever she lived. She had a lot of problems in her life, as most of us do. But I understand one thing about Miss Tommy was, she did not let the circumstances in her life stop her. She just took those circumstances and turned them into opportunities. A good lesson for all of us, because all of us have situations that we run into that are beyond our control so many times. Instead of complaining about the situations we have, maybe we need to be like Miss Tommy and take those situations and turn them into opportunities. She loved the family, loved to take time to share with her family. I'm going to give you an opportunity right now. If someone would like to say something that special about Miss Tommy in your life, if you'd come to the platform and share with the rest of us, we'll give you that opportunity. And they'd like for you to come up here, please, ma'am.
Okay, I'd like to take this opportunity on behalf of the Senior Center and all of my family that got to know Tommy, how much we all loved her and that she loved all of us. She never had a bad word to say about anyone, and she loved everyone. You could tell that because of all the hugs she gave everyone and all the I love yous she would say. Tommy was very active in the Senior Center for 15 years. In the last month, she did woodworking, pottery, painting, game time, and canasta. She also bowled with the Senior League for over 10 years. She enjoyed life to the fullest. She also won many medals in the Senior Games, and that held every year, including many awards for her painting, photography, and writing. She loved her hats that made her happy. She loved going to our lake place and being on the boat. She said that she was so happy to be on the lake, in the sun, and feeling free. She would be missed by all, especially me, because she was a sister I never had. She also enjoyed the free movies over many years. Tommy, Carol Nerney, and myself would go together. We were known as the Three Musketeers, three sisters forever. I just know that God needed another angel, and Tommy sure was that angel. To all her family and friends, on behalf of the Senior Center and my family, we are all very grateful that Tommy was in our lives.
Anyone else?
If I have introduced myself already, I'm Travis. I'm her probably her oldest grandchild. 2012 was a hard year for me. I was in Salisbury, I was in a bad place. And Granny Tommy came through for me at the last minute. She gave me a place to live, and it had its ups and downs, but she was a fighter, and she fought to keep me in line, and she did a good job of it, because I'm still here today because of her. And there's not a day that will go by where I won't think about her and what she did for me. She gave me a second chance at life, and I got to meet Jennifer because of it. And that's all I'll say. Thank you.
I can get through this. I just wanted to share my gift to celebrate an amazing lady. We'll be very missed. We love you, Aunt Tommy. This one's for you. Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. But now am found, was blind, but now I see. 'Twas grace that taught my heart to fear, and grace my fears relieved. How precious did that grace appear the hour I first believed. And though this flesh and heart shall fail, and mortal life shall cease, I shall possess beyond the veil a life of joy and peace. Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. But now am found, was blind, but now I see.
Anyone else? Family has requested a special song that I guess was really dear to her. Thank you for sharing that. I'll Fly Away.
I'll fly away to that home. fly away. No more cold iron shackles on my feet. I'll fly away. I'll fly away, oh glory. I'll fly away in the morning when I die. Hallelujah, by and by. I'll fly away.
Hearing what you've said today about Miss Tommy from family and friends, Proverbs 18:24 says, a person who has friends must show themselves friendly. You see, it's one thing to say we have friends. It's another thing for those friends to really be a friend. You know, you can see we've got a lot of acquaintances, but to really say how many real friends we have is the real thing. So he said, for the person to have friends, we must show ourselves friendly. Undoubtedly, Miss Tommy didn't have any problem making friends. Solomon said, again, friends must show themselves friendly, not just to say I am your friend, but to do things that give evidence that they really are a friend. Again, thinking about all the things that Miss Tommy did for people, obviously to me that she was that kind of person who not only wanted to be your friend, but actually showed how much that she wanted to be your friend by the things that she did for you. By the things that she shared and by the things that she cared about, says truly that she really was a person who understands if you're going to have friends, you got to make yourself friendly. Our oldest daughter was just a little kid at the time, just about 2 or 3 years old, the first church we were in. And our daughter didn't like to make friends real easy. And one of the ladies in the church said, I'm going to do whatever it takes to make that little girl my friend. I think Miss Tommy would have been that kind of person too. She'd have made every opportunity to make our daughter Remy her friend. John says in 15:15, Jesus says, henceforth I call you no longer servants, for the servant does not know what the Lord does. But I have called you friends, for everything that I've heard from my Father, I will make known to you. It is again obvious to me that Miss Tommy had a lot of friends. But the most important friend that you just sang about, the most important friend that we could ever make in our life is to make friendship with the Lord Jesus Christ. Like Miss Tommy, the Lord likes to listen to us too. Family, you don't have Miss Tommy to talk to anymore, but you got the Lord. You can still talk to him. And you know what? I think he'll give you just as good advice as Miss Tommy ever gave you. He loved us to the degree that nobody else ever loved us in this world. He loved us to the degree that he was willing to go to the cross and suffer and die for us so that we might have everlasting life. One difference in making Jesus a friend and making you and I as friends is this. Our earthly friendship will come to an end. You had a friend here, Miss Tommy. That friendship came to an end when her life came to an end. But even if our earthly friendships come to an end, as they will, having a friend by the name of Jesus isn't an earthly thing. It is an eternal thing. The friendships we have here will last only for a little while. But the friend that we make in the Lord Jesus Christ not only will be in this life, will be forever and ever and ever. So make the same friend that Miss Tommy did as your friend, the Lord Jesus Christ. Solomon also says, a friend loves at all times, and a brother is born for adversity. A friend loves at all times, but sometimes those real friends are the friends who are there for us when we need them the most. On a Saturday afternoon, after Thanksgiving, look around just for a minute to see just a small amount of the friends that Miss Tommy made for them to be here today. So that friend who will be with you in the most difficult times, I think they are here with you today. Miss Tommy left a note that she wanted to be read at a time like this. I love you. Always have and always will. Even from heaven. I love all my family with all my heart. If I didn't have you, I probably would have been gone a long time ago. Love Grandma, Granny, Mom. Let's pray. Father, I thank you that all of us can have a friend that is closer than a brother, and that his name is the Lord Jesus Christ. So I pray, Father, right now for this family that's going through this difficulty, that they would call on this friend, the Lord Jesus Christ, to be with them and console them and help them in this hour of their lives, Father, like never before. Thank you, Father, for the friends that came today to show to this family how much Miss Tommy meant to them. And I pray, Father, as the days and the weeks go by, that these friends will continue to reach out to this family, love on them, administer them, and care for them. Thank you, Lord Jesus, that we have a friend closer than a brother, and you are the one, our Redeemer, our friend, our Savior, Jesus Christ. In his name I pray, amen.